Now we're going to come full circle, moving even further east to Fred Tsao. And Andrea said something about the fact that their Regeneration Society Foundation and their project started with well-being and health. And it resonates a lot with your own personal transformation, Fred, and how it led to family transformation and then to business transformation. So tell us about your worldview and how you look at that from your own perspective.
Thank you.
Hello?
Yeah. Maybe I'll do this too.
Yes, please, please.
Talks better chi when you're standing up than sitting down. All right, we still, of course, in the family zones, need to have a story. So my great-great-great-grandfather was a scholar. In other words, he studies. And in scholars in China, you go for exam, and if you don't pass, you become a poor teacher. And so a poor teacher with a rich wife was very difficult for him. He decided that his children should not learn how to read and write, but he's a teacher. So my great-great-grandfather is illiterate. I never understood that until much later. The education is not what about reading and writing. Education can be displaced in daily life. So although he never read the book, but his father was a scholar, deep into a specific scholastic life. And therefore, what it does, it opens up much more possibility, restricting from your identity of being scholastic and educated. So an uneducated man does not mean he's uneducated, and an educated man doesn't mean he's educated. Something I learned. Now, over the years, you know, in 1906, finally, my great-grandfather had some skill, and then he opened up shop on the bun. It's a big thing to have a wharf. 1906 was the registration I could find. So I just picked that date as the family business beginning. So we grew up in an environment in Shanghai, very turbulent. At that time, Shanghai ruled by 8 countries. Very complicated, all split up in their rental boundaries. One Shanghai, but it's rented to 8 countries. So during the time, China is very turbulent. And of course, 49, there is communists and we are the capitalists. So we ran away. And then we become nomads without identity. Actually, my grandfather became Brazilian. My father became Malaysian. And I have all kinds, Japanese, English, American, Canadian, I'm Thai. But of course, only thing I like is Thai food, okay? So anyway, imaginary lines separating us called nations. We're now in a global reality. Now what I want to tell you another story, which was my kind of a second life, but become my main life in the drive. What we did, first of all, I'm very interested in sustainability, being a family business. And I studied sustainability. In 1995, I formed a East-West Center for Cultural Research and Development. Because how we see the world inform how we think and feel and choose to act on it. And if you look at all conflict, isn't it just a conflict of because we see the world differently? And we actually will never see the world the same. Because the world as we see it is only our perception. We all live in our own world. But there's one world that we are the same. Our inner world is the same. But we choose an external world, and for sure we have conflict. Because in that external world is a world of perception, which we all know, right? Now, that journey went on, and we published many books in this area, especially looking into our Eastern tradition. 35 books to be exact. Then I decided to write a book myself. The first book I wrote was Quantum Leadership. It's exactly this topic. Consciousness is the mother of capital. A new consciousness for business. If we look at today, what has happened in the world isn't a world that have humanity crisis. We are so far away because we're so indulged in the indulgence life of materialism and consumerism and waste that we have lost touch of our humanity. So Adam Smith's theory of the moral sentiment does not come back until with SDG, with ESG, with impact investment. Nothing happened by chance. Everything is evolving. There's only one thing that we can perceive in our world outside, change. Change is the only constant. But what is the essence of change? We're all evolving. We can understand from our history. So thank God, underneath there's something that doesn't change, that we will awaken. So I've wrote since that first book during COVID, two more books, and I'm now on the third book. The second book is called Dawn of a New Era of Well-Being. Inside there, we look at scientific, and many people contribute in the book about the arrival of this new era. And if you talk to a quantum scientist, or you talk to a Chinese mysticist, they know well-being is just coherency. You think about, if you're being just you, your mind, body, spirit, just you, you have no stress because you're being you. You're well. You can only be well if you're you. Now, how many of you can claim you know you? We're now in the age of self-actualization, except we don't know who self is. We cannot unite. It's not out there. We all live in a different perception world of information coming into our eyes, ears, nose, sensory organs. So in 2012, we have a new charter. It took 5 years. We decided legacy, succession, all that must be based on the foundation of nature of human being and impact. Why? Because those who are self-serving will fight and kill each other like we see in history. But if we serve the whole system is life. The universe is life. We are life components. If you don't realize the I is within the we, and the we is beyond humanity, we have a situation. We have a situation that we have found freedom in our capitalistic system, market economy. That exact freedom is driving a lot of improvement, but at a time, it's also driving us to lost into this space of self-indulgence. Therefore, we have a crisis of humanity. We have a crisis because we have unchecked market economy. That's why we have SDG 17, ESG, and impact. This is a response for people on the ground with the theory of moral sentiments coming that we need some boundaries and we need a direction for humanity. You know one thing good about family business? We still have some humanity and not that loss. Family business is grounded on shared experience and community. We do not think of the business as just separated from us. It's part of us. The business of doing is shared experience. So employees, shared experience, share aspiration, share destiny. It's a very different kind of humanity. And we are quick losing it too. Now, as the world changed, role changed. Now, today, no doubt, in the market economy, businesses has a new role in the world because it's the most powerful economic sector that drives the world. And family business, with whatever remain of our humanity, can play a very insignificant role to the change. As the system has so much drag, unless we have somebody with no monkey in the back that we decide. Our new charter has surrendered all wealth of the family to a trust that will serve humanity. For we believe not we get weaker from our old generation, we will evolve to be better and more productive, We do not need prudence, legacy, wealth protection, all those things that are actually passed on from fear. We cannot create from free. We must free from the good things of family, bad things of family business, and to believing each generation we can contribute more. And therefore, we will grow into focusing on contributing more instead of protecting our legacy, protecting our wealth, and be prudent. What is prudent? With fear, you see risk. With love, you see opportunity. We cannot create from fear. It is a time the family business should rise. And for my family, it's done really well since the charter. For now, we all work for the whole supplying service to the whole system. The capital is consciousness. What my side interest has become my biggest focus and will become our biggest business, helping humanity awaken, shift consciousness, and doing business reform so we have a better future. When we shift our consciousness, we shift everything. Consciousness is capital, it's knowledge, it's willpower, it's everything. That is the most precious humanity capital, which we have lost. Money is not capital. We have lost our way. Money is created by us for change, in exchange. If we look at nature, if we found our nature is whole. Our nature is love. Our nature is creativity. Our nature is not this limiting person that's struggling with sustainability. If you want to find happiness, you'll never find. If you want to find sustainability, at best, you got damage control. We are all there to create, to make impact. And the world have spoken. We have spoken. Impact is a direction. ESG are boundaries for transition. And for us, we need to focus consciousness. So I have many consciousness movements, a different life, and I have decided as the steward of this generation, I will do succession by a stewardship program and purpose. And that, what we needed to do, is to find out who we are, wake up to our nature, and live our calling. So a new dedicated business based on school of life and creating a new group based on consciousness, a new way of living, and a new world. Thank you.